Hello all, in this particular video, we are solving a new kind of technique called Patrick's method, okay? So, this is one of the new technique to find the minimal sum, okay, of a given Boolean function. So, examination question will be examination will be asked in such a way that find the minimum, minimize the following Boolean function by Patrick's method and find the minimal sum, okay? As you could see here, before I start solving the problem, the very first thing is your 50 to 60% of the problem, it is a known problem. Why? Because you will be applying QM method first. After you are completing finding the minimum sum, okay, you will be finding and applying your Patrick's method here. Okay, so we will quickly start with the problem here. So that is my first step, that is after giving the minterms here. So step 1 is I will write all the minterms with its Boolean values in ascending order. Second step, I will start grouping each other with depending on total number of 1s present here. So 4 contains single 1, 5 will contains 2 1s, 7 and 14 contains 3 1s, 15 contains 4 1s. This is about second step. Coming to the third step, I will start comparing with each and every number here. So 4 and 5 is compared with 5 and 7. Is there any 2 bit number difference? I could not find out any 2 bits. 4 and 5 is compared with rest all of the set, which there is no comparison at all. Next, 5 and 7 is compared with rest. There is nothing. So in step 3, I could not found that any 2 bits difference here. There is more than 2 bits difference. So that in step 4, I will be writing it as no further elimination. I am not able to further eliminate all these any bits in that particular number. Coming to step 5. So soon after this particular step, I will be writing all the minterms, a pair of minterms, in one order, the same order, the Boolean values of that particular minterms. Suppose 4, 5. So 4, 5, what is the value? I am having 0, 1, 0. 0, 1, 0 I will be writing. And what is the respective value? It is A bar B C bar. So I will be leaving dash here. It is only A bar B C bar. Similarly, 4, 12. 4, 12, I have dash 100. It is dash 100. What is 100? It is B, C bar, D bar. In the same way, I will be writing for rest all other things. So, this is about step 5. Next, in step 6, considering these, the prime implicants, I will list all the prime implicants first. As you could see in the table, please look at only here, don't look at rest all other things as of now. I'll be going step by step. See, first you will be listing all the prime implicants here and then you will be writing the respective numbers of each pair. For example, 4, 5 is A bar, B, C bar. Next, it is 4, 12. The same column you will be copying here. Okay, so after that, what is the minterms that he has given you? Consider all the minterms here. I have 4, 5, 7, 12, 14 and 15. I will be writing 4 as M4, 5 as M5, 7 as M7, such that M12, M14 and M15. Okay. Now, wherever 4 is present, you will be marking that particular block. Okay. So, here I am having 4. So, here I am having 4. Next, 5. So where I am having 5? Here I am having 5. So this block. Here I am having 5. So this particular block. So like that, you will be marking 7, 12, 14 and 15. See, after marking this, you will name each row and each columns here. So how to name this row? I will be naming this particular row as this as P, Q, R, S, T and U. Any name, and this column as C1, C2, C3, C4, C5 and C6. Okay, now you might ask me one question: is there any essential prime implicants? Check if there is any essential prime implicants. I couldn't see any essential prime implicants in this problem. Okay, so I'll be considering all the prime implicants here. This is where your half of the problem is solved. 50% of your problem is being solved here. Now, step 7. This is the very important step. Please hold your mind. Observe here. I am applying Patrick's methods to find the minimal solution here. So, what is Patrick's method? How to apply for this? So, there are few things to remember. 3 points. What is the first point? Add the terms column wise. I am having several terms here which is being marked. So, I must add it in column wise. Suppose if I am taking C1, I am adding P and Q. If I consider C2, here I am adding P and R. So, if I consider C3, I am adding R and T. So, this is what remove the next add the terms in column wise. After which, remove the redundant terms. Remove the what do you mean by redundant terms? The repetition terms has to be removed. So, for that we use 2 De Morgan's law. We have 2 formulas. One is A plus B into A plus C can be written as A plus BC. That is rule number 12. A plus AB can be written as A. You, as of now, you just keep this formula in your mind. When we go on solving the problem, you start applying that particular formula there. So, keeping these points in mind, will we start solving the Patrick's method problem. So, what is the first step? Add the terms column wise. So, my formula will be summation of C1 into C2 into C3 into C4, C5 and C6. So, what is my C1? It is P plus Q. What is my C2? It is P plus R. What is my C3? It is R plus T. What is my C4? It is Q plus S. C4 is these two, Q and S. This particular thing I will be adding. Next, C5 it is S plus U. C6 it is T plus U. What is the respective min terms of these? I will be writing P plus Q means what? P plus Q is, what is the min term associated with it? It is min term 4. Next it is min term 5. 7, 12, 14 and 15. This is for your reference. When you start solving n number of problems, I hope so you will be comfortable. When you are starting initially, you must concentrate in each and every step over there. Okay, come back to the point here. What is my rule that I am having? If it is in the form of A plus B into A plus C, I can write it this as A plus BC. Here, if you could find here, I have P plus QR here into T plus, okay. How did I came here? A plus B into A plus C. See here, if you consider only the P terms here. Here I have P plus Q into P plus R, which can be written as P plus QR. P is common, Q and R. What is the formula? A plus B into A plus B can be written as A plus BC. In the similar way, I have T here and I have T here, these two terms, R plus T into T plus U, I can write it as T plus RU. Okay. Next, here I have S as common, so S plus Q plus S and into S plus U, I can write it as S plus QU. Okay. So, this is one step. Next, I will start multiplying this one term with this. This one term with this. Okay. Next, this with this and this with second term. So, it is PT plus. See, this I would like to suggest you one more thing. When you are solving here, please try to write it in alphabetical order. For your reference, it would be very much convenient. Okay. So, PT plus P into RU, that is PRU plus QRT plus QRU, this and this, into my remaining thing is S plus QU. Then I will multiply all these terms with S plus all these terms with QU. which you will be getting in this particular step. So next I have one more rule, that is here if I find, I want to just almost, what is my main intention in this problem? I have to remove the redundant terms. What do you mean by redundant terms? The repetitive terms. Those things I have to remember. Remove. So here a plus ab is equal to a. So if you could find here, I have got these expression. So in this particular expression, see I have, let us consider first, I will write PST plus PRSU. See PRSU, RSU, if there is anywhere RSU here, here I am having three terms as common. RSU is common, here I have RSU is common. I will be considering the first term and I will be writing PRSU here. Next, I have QRST. Okay, so QRST, this here I am having QRST plus PQ, here I am having PQRU. So here QRU is common, QRU is common. So I will be writing the first term, that is PQTU here and QRU. Okay, I will be repeating once again. Again I will be repeating. Just remember here, first term is PST, the second term PRSU. Next, I have QRST, QRSU, in which three terms are common, that is my QRS. So I will remove this particular term QRSU, I will be writing only QRST. A plus AB I will be writing as A. Next, I have PQTU, I will be writing PQTU plus PQU. So here in this term PQU is common, I will be removing this particular term, I will be only considering this PQTU here. Next, I have QRTU, QRU and QRU I have common here, which I will be considering. So QRU as a common here, that I will be considering. Next, after finding this step, the next is, we'll name all these as F1, function 1, function 2, F3, F4 and F5. Next, see if you observe this particular step, which is having the minimal function, that is F1, this particular PST and QRU is having the minimal sum, only 3 terms. So I will be considering that particular F1, that is P plus S plus T, I will be writing this as sum of products, that is minimal sum, okay, that is P plus S plus T. What is my P here? P means it is A bar B C bar, plus S means what? S means A B D bar, I will be writing A B D bar, plus B C D. T means what? T means B C D, I will be writing B C D. Next, it is QRU, Q plus R plus U, if you substitute the values, I will be getting this. Okay, so this is how a minimal sum using your Petrick's method can be done. Okay, so this will be asked in your examination, he can ask you to explain what is Petrick's method with a small example. Here it is the example. For the same Quinn-McCluskey's method, after completing this, you will be start applying your Petrick's method. So consider these 3 points. One is, add the terms column wise, remove the redundant terms and apply the formula. So this is all about Petrick's method. If you have any doubts, you could leave in the comment section. Thank you.